lines. It's not something that I believe in. I think Christine might want to have a chat with her priest at her Catholic church on what their doctrine is on that question. Just a suggestion. We could just look at Christine's own current lifetime. And I think one of the explanatory factors here, big one, might be the influence of Judgy Joyce. We were treated recently to a story about Judgy Joyce having quite a blow up at a little tangle over a stop sign, and the police came and she was shouting at the cop, if I recall correctly. Well, it seems like this Frank Costanza level temperament spilled over as well at a recent family dinner at a hibachi grill. And my very first question, Christine, is why were you out to dinner at a hibachi grill? Am I not mistaken that Bobby is a hibachi chef, your husband? Doesn't he do this stuff himself?
He sure does. We call it hibachi.
Hibachi, that's right. And you were very proud of that.
He's great.
So why are you going to pay other people for the hibachi skills that you have right under your own roof?
Well, the stovetop grill that we had in the on I-4 Lane, we wound up giving it to the new homeowners because we were moving into an apartment and we weren't allowed to bring it.
Oh, so the whole setup.
So there's no
way.
We need the hibachi, part of hibachi. Because I was driving, and Bobby wasn't with me, but he Maybe we could do another home stretch. I feel like people are not reading my emails correctly, and it's happening a lot. know, sometimes, well, you know, sometimes maybe you look at yourself when more than one time it happens. But I looked at Justin, and I'm like, am I just the girl that can't find the sun to you all? Is that all I am?
It seems like there's a recent Taylor Swift lyric that we have applied to you before that might once again crop up in this context when you are trying to identify the source of a problem, and at some point you realize the source of the problem and you just own up to it and you realize who it is.
Well, I do do that. I have learned that from therapy.
And so what would you say, for example, as you look at all of these issues in your life?
It's the side of the problem.
Exchange Bank, member FDIC.
administration has made investments, but more needs to be done. A New York appeals court refused to postpone former President Trump's hush money as an appellate court continues to review a limited gag order the judge placed on Mr. Trump. You're listening to ABC News.
From the greatest country in the world, broadcast from the tippy top of the world-famous Fox News headquarters in New York City. It is Fox Across America with Jimmy Failla, a man who did not blame the eclipse. on climate change. I want credit for this. I said it to you yesterday, as sure as the moon would cross the sun's path, somebody was going to cite climate change, and they did it on The View.
The View is awful.
We're going to get into it in this hour just to have a laugh, because the world's on fire. Why not roast a few radio marshmallows? You're welcome to pick up a stick and join me. 888-788-9910 if you want to be a part of this thing. Also, the phone number if you don't want to be a part of this thing.
You're just another dirtbag.
A lot of people feel that way, but no judgments here. There is not a more flawed member of this audience than the guy coming through your speakers right now, meaning me. I am a hot mess.
Fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life.
Well, fat, drunk, and stupid has got me a long way, so I'm going to dance with the gal I brought to the ball. 888-788-9910. You know the phone number. You can be a Republican, you can be a Democrat, Libertarian, Independent. We don't care. It is a talk show. The only thing we ever ask is that you don't be a... There it is. Happy Tuesday. If you missed me on Fox and Friends this morning, we posted it on the Fox Across America website. I was just on with Stuart Varney. We will post that clip there as well. And tonight I am on with Laura Ingraham, who is, of course, thrilled to have me on her show every Tuesday.
What a fraud!
Oh, it's a tough crowd, but that's all right. I can take it, because we're going to go on offense a little bit in this hour. Two things are happening. One, Evan Roberts is coming by. He is, in the New York area, a bit of a sports talk radio legend. And he just wrote a book about the New York Mets.
This is the biggest schmuck I've ever met.
Yeah, I don't know who wants to read this, but I know there's a lot of long-suffering Mets fans out there, and we have a lot of respect for Evan. He's had quite a huge, he's had a huge career. He's a WFAN. I mean, he's the biggest sports talk station in the world, and he's got a book out, and if you know anything about this show, it's that we're not afraid to plug somebody's book to the point that you're willing to punch us in the face for doing it.
That's true. That is true.
Although, to be clear, my New York Times bestseller, The Cancel Culture Dictionary, I haven't heard a lot about it lately because I've been promoting Jesse Waters' book at gunpoint. But today, we will put down the Derringer. We will move over to sports and talk with Evan. But before that can happen, since we're in sports parlance, I will take a victory lap because I want credit for this. I said it to you yesterday on the show. I go, you know, the nice thing about an eclipse, I says, is for 4 minutes, you're going to get something happening in the news that we don't have to turn into a political battleground. And I caught myself in real time and played the buzzer and said, no, you're probably wrong about this, Jimmy, because in this day and age, everything comes with a side. It's the dumbest thing in the world. You know, two celebrities start dating. Taylor Swift's dating Travis Kelce. Everybody's got a hot take. This is bad for Republicans or it's bad for Democrats. This, you don't understand. It's the dumbest thing in the world, and everybody gets divided. And
somebody had a barbecue in their mouth.
And now we're fighting. Okay, I'm trying to be that other thing. I'm trying to be an old-school talk show where we can agree or disagree, but we're going to treat each other okay. We're just going to have a good time. That's all I've got, man. I don't have answers. Okay, I'm a 47-year-old man who plays video games. If you are counting on me to save the Republic, we're in a hell of a whole lot of trouble right now. I gotta be honest.
He's a lousy dad, but he's right.
So I try to be that port in the storm. But when I get one right, I do want credit, because nobody's ever copied off me on a test. But here is The View, running through a host of doomsday conspiracies. I laugh, because Sonny Hostin, with a straight face, tries to claim that the eclipse and the earthquake have to do with climate change.
Oh, shut up, woman.
But have a peek here. It's clip one.
I mean, I have to say, Karen DuPeace, our wonderful,
oh my
one of our wonderful makeup artists, when the earthquake was happening, she put her coat on, and she was like, Jesus is coming.
I'm out.
I'm leaving. We've got a solar eclipse. We've got
ran down the hallway.
The rapture is here. And then also I learned that the cicadas are coming.
There's different kinds of cicadas.
The good cicadas and the bad
stuff. For the first time in many, many years.
No, every 17 years has happened.
Well, that's not what I read, but maybe, better. All those things together would maybe lead one to believe that, you know, either climate change exists or something is really
returning.
Earthquakes are not at the mercy of climate change. It's underground. No.
It happens. And the eclipse, they've known about the eclipse coming because eclipses happen, and they actually can say when these things are going to happen. So all these folks who are saying, you know, it's a sign from God, God doesn't give you warning. Okay? You think he gave kid people at the Tower of Babel warning, oh, I'm about to jack y'all up? No.
First of all, it's never a good sign when Whoopi Goldberg is serving as the fact checker, because Whoopi Goldberg is famously the same woman who nominated Jill Biden for Surgeon General.
Dr. Jill becomes a Surgeon General. His wife.
Yeah, Joe Biden's
wife, because she's, you know, he would never do it, but she, it's, yeah, she's a hell of a doctor. She's an amazing doctor.
She's a doctor in an
yeah. I could be wrong.
Maybe, right? Yeah, I think she's a teacher, but...
Except she's not a medical doctor. And to be clear, this is kind of par for the course on The View. Usually, like, if you heard the beginning of the Joe Biden clip, they start to applaud it. That goes on The View. And in this instance, thankfully, they did fact-check her, but we knew it was coming somewhere. There's a little more of that on social media. I don't want to dwell. I just found it so funny because I knew it would happen. Like, we can't, and it's such a sad commentary on the day that we're living in, is that everything becomes an opportunity to advance a political agenda. Even in a fleeting moment like that, where Sonny Halston is making, you know, throwaway comments, but it's the biggest, you know, example I can give you in terms of why we're doing everything wrong in this day and age. Okay, the race to fund the stuff. Okay, the race to link whatever your agenda happens to be with the goings-on of the world. About the same political issues. We've been fighting about them for 40 years. We've been fighting about immigration reform for 40 years. We've been fighting about abortion for 50 years. Gun control around forever. We've been fighting about these issues forever. What's changed is the way we fight about it, meaning social media, 24-hour news cycle. It's so much harder to cut through all the clutter that people have to deal with extremes, which is how you wind up all the next clip I'm going to play you, which is Whoopi Goldberg saying, leave abortion alone because of the Ten Commandments. Now, I gotta be honest, okay? Abortion isn't in the Ten Commandments. She makes the case that that's why we should leave it alone. But if you were really gonna get technical, it probably violates the Ten Commandments. Follows them. Okay, seeing as you have a commandment out there called Thou Shalt Not Kill. Okay, but I'm not trying to get into the